The CTA's ambitious overhaul of the red and purple lines on the north side enters its next major phase on Sunday. The Bryn Mawr, Berwyn, Argyle, and Lawrence stations are set to shut down for reconstruction until 2024, with temporary stations opening at Bryn Mawr and Argyle. The revamp of the century-old rail system is being overseen by three firms, including one that started in a Southside attic and has grown to have national goals. Chicago Tonight's Nick Blumberg reports.
The $2.1 billion Red-Purple Modernization effort is the single largest project in the CTA's history. For something so massive, the transit agency needed to hire extra hands to oversee the design and construction process.
It's been a huge opportunity for our firm to be a part of this project. So now that we're at this critical moment, you really get to see the design come to life. That's the most exciting part of engineering for me.
Rashod Johnson always had an aptitude for math and science. Speaking of science, he and I are both fully vaccinated. At St. Ignatius, his physics teacher suggested engineering.
And I was like, nah, I'm good. I don't want to drive trains for a living. He's like, not that type of engineering, Rashod.
Johnson took an internship with a construction firm and discovered he loved civil engineering.
Any and everything that has to do with infrastructure. So whether or not it's bridges, roads, buildings, trains, planes, and automobiles, civil engineering has something to do with it.
After college, he was working for a trade association, but Johnson says he always had an entrepreneurial spirit, and he saw an opening. So he started the Roderick Group. Roderick's his middle name.
Started it in my attic on the south side of Chicago, and now we've grown today to 230 people in five states of Puerto Rico.
Even as the company, now known as Ardmore Roderick, expands, Johnson says he hasn't forgotten what it was like when the staff was tiny.
I've done the marketing, I've done the PR, I've done the engineering, I've done the design, the construction management, I've taken out the garbage. So now that we've grown into this company where I don't do a lot of this work, I still understand the value.
I really like the environment with Ardmore Roderick. You don't feel that you are like just a number, you know.
Robert Dranizarek was one of the company's very first employees.
Rashod has made an effort to make us diverse, and it's been a real blessing for our company. When you get to know people that have different backgrounds, it really opens your eyes to a lot of things, and you grow as a person, not just as an engineer.
Johnson says he doesn't just want a diverse firm. He wants to help the next wave of engineers like him through working in the community and raising money to get students interested in STEM.
I think minority students, black kids in particular, seem to be afraid of math and science for some reason. You can't create a love for math and science in high school or college. You have to be a kid who knows and loves math at 5 and 6 and 7 years old. That's where the future engineers come from.
As for Ardmore Roderick's future, Johnson says he wants the company to be nationwide by 2025 and to stay true to its values.
60% of our firm is diverse, and it's very purposeful. We give opportunities for people that typically would not have opportunities in engineering and construction. We have not had a lower quality. In fact, I would tell you we've had better quality because of our commitment to diversity within the firm.
For Chicago Tonight, I'm Nick Blumberg.
And by the way, that construction company Rashod Johnson interned for, it was called Walsh Construction, and its massive joint venture, Walsh Floor, is the construction firm whose work on the CTA revamp, Johnson's company, helps oversee.